Warning: all our videos are made only for educational purposes and to demonstrate scientific laws that we verify. These experiments must be supervised and we are not responsible for an incorrect execution of an experiment done by others. We do not encourage in any way that you misuse our experiments to do violent things and harm others.
Hello everyone, welcome back to chemIst Balesni, and today we'll see how to make fireballs by a substance which is nitrocellulose.
The first thing that we need is nitric acid, and we are going to distill it in order to purify it.
In fact, what happened in our previous experiment is that we make our nitric acid pure react with copper to see how this this acid is the only one to dissolve copper, and so now we need to distill it.
Is to put the beaker in a bowl and fill the bowl with water and also some ice cubes, because the reaction between the two acids is very exothermic. Then we are going to put the cotton into the acid and wait to absorb everything.
So what's happening in the reaction is that cellulose has really many hydroxy groups in its form, and when we make it react with nitric acid, a nitro group is formed in substitution of the hydroxy group, and so is that this nitro group that contains really much energy, and this energy when it's freed, it determines the explosion of the nitrocellulose.
With water, because there are some remains of the acids which are very dangerous for us and also for the final solution that ignite itself. After this, we are going to add some sodium bicarbonate in the solution in order to neutralize.
In fact, what happens is that we see an yeast-based reaction that, as he said, neutralizes the acid, the nitric and sulfuric acid in the solution. So once our nitrocellulose is freed from acid, we can let it dry and use it for the experiment.
The gun cotton, and we are going to use some paper towel and wrap it really well, because the solution won't ignite if it is not really dry.
has given the best that he has.
So the last thing that we want you to know is about something about the nitro group. In fact, this group is always present in explosive and things like this because it contains the right properties to make a substance explode. In fact, it both contains a strong bond that uses its reaction to explode, and it also contains oxygen, which is the most important thing for a reaction to start, because in fact the oxygen that is present in the air is not sufficient to explode as fast as we see in a normal explosion. So guys, the experiment is over, and last thing that we want you to know is the precautions. In fact, this experiment can be really dangerous because nitrocellulose is a really particular material that easily ignite and explode. So we want you to know that if this is not done for educational purposes, you should not attempt this experiment. And also you have to know that the acids are really corrosive, so you need to wear gloves, masks and things like this. And obviously, always you have to remember that this experiment is really dangerous, and you have to think about what you're doing.
So everyone, if you like this video, please let us know in the comments and share your feelings with us. If you want to see more amazing experiments, synthesis and other explosions like this, please visit our channel and subscribe to it. So for today's all,
thanks for watching.